Hi there, students! Welcome back to our virtual class. And for today's video, I am going to present to you the first lesson under Module 1, which covers the tools of criminal investigation, such as information, interview, interrogation, and instrumentation. In this lesson, students will have a recap on the basics of criminal investigation. This is Jan Vincent P. Casar, and I will discuss the lessons here based on my own point of understanding and interpretation as a registered criminologist. The views and opinions expressed here do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of Philippine College of Science and Technology, my colleagues in the academy, and any law enforcement agencies. Any content provided herein are my personal opinion and are not intended to malign any religion, ethnic group, club, organization, company, individual, or anyone or anything. The music, images, illustrations, or icons used in this video belongs to the rightful owners. No copyright infringement is intended in this video. Generally, an investigation refers to the process of collecting information in order to reach some goal. So just like, for example, if you're going to purchase a car, you need to collect information about the reliability and the performance of that vehicle for you to be able to identify or increase the likelihood of buying a good quality car. Applying this principle to the criminal realm, a criminal investigation refers to the process of collecting information or evidence about a crime in order to determine if a crime has been committed, identify the perpetrator, apprehend the perpetrator, and provide evidence to support a conviction in court. If the first three objectives are successfully attained, then the crime can be said to be solved. Several other outcomes, such as recovering stolen property, deterring individuals from engaging in criminal behaviors, and satisfying crime victims, have also been associated in the process. So, let us now proceed with your learning objectives. At the end of this lesson, students are expected to identify the different tools of criminal investigation. Okay? So we will going to discuss the three tools of criminal investigation one at a time. Are you ready? If you're ready, then I am also ready. Alright, let's proceed. The three tools of criminal investigation. The first tool of criminal investigation that we will go into tackle is the information. These are knowledge derived from any source which can be used as a basis or as a means for decision making to facilitate the successful termination of a criminal investigation. Information is the first vital key of successful investigation. Meaning, without appropriate or adequate information, investigators will encounter difficulties in deciding where they should start or continue their inquiry. Therefore, the ability to secure and systematically collect information is a major asset of a good and competent investigator. Generally, there are two methods of obtaining information. The first method is the overt and the second method is the covert method. Okay? When we say overt method, these are the visible way or means of obtaining information. It's like, for example, conducting interview, collecting information by means of patrol, crime scene search, performance of regular police activities, and even custodial interrogation. In contrast, we have the covert method. This is the secret way of obtaining information. This is the opposite of the overt. Okay? So, example of this is surveillance. We also have undercover assignments, entrapment, and tactical interrogation. So, let us proceed on the sources of information. The first source of information is the physical source of information. Example is the crime scene. Okay? Crime scene is the place where the crime was committed. All pieces of evidence secured from the crime scene is reviewed as to its information potential. Crime scene evidence, to be specific, physical evidences from the crime scene often has significant value in providing the officer with suspect tracing information, or otherwise known as tracing evidence. Okay? We also have wiretapping and electronic surveillance or eavesdropping. When you listen to unspoken interactions using a device that gather and amplify sounds, that is called as electronic surveillance. If you listen to a conversation without the use of any device, that is known as eavesdropping. The type of information obtained from these sources may be considered as physical form. The information may actually be in a real form, like for example, fingerprint. Meaning to say, the value of information will be useless if the investigator failed to retrieve or receive such evidences at the right time. Okay? The type of evidence developed may be called as physical evidence. These are evidence addressed to the senses of the court, as when objects are exhibited for the personal observation of the judge. It is also called as real evidence. When we say real evidence, these are any kind of objects associated with the investigation, but it must be a tangible item. The second source of information we have is the documentary sources. These are any type of information of a printed nature or data otherwise recovered and stored for retrieval. Such information may be obtained within the police agency or from other criminal justice agencies, and even from other sources not connected with law enforcement. Example, public records, school records, employment records, and the like. The type of information obtained from these sources may be considered as written form, and the type of evidence developed may be called as documentary evidence. The last source of information we have is the human source of information. Under this, we have voluntary informant. These are persons who provide information regardless of their background. Okay? They provide information without hidden motive or payment. We also have informants with hidden motives. Okay? These are individuals who provide the police with information for self-serving reasons. They do not demand for money or reward for the information they have given. However, serving as an informant benefits them in some fashion. Example, revenge or jealousy. Okay? We also have here the paid informants or informers. These are individuals who receive monetary compensation for their information given. In the majority of cases, the informant is either actively involved in crime or has close contact with those who are involved in crime. The type of information obtained from these sources may be considered as sensory form. When we say sensory form, these are the outward manifestations of a criminal event that can be perceived by our five senses. The type of evidence developed may be called as testimonial evidence, the most common form of evidence, and it is obtained through interview and interrogation. Okay? The second tool of criminal investigation is interview and interrogation. Interview is the casual but systematic conversation with the person who may possess knowledge relevant to a crime under investigation but no personal reason to withhold information. Meaning, it is a communication involving two or more persons for the purpose of obtaining information relative to a crime under investigation. The information gathering process will vary depending on the cooperative attitude of the subject, the perspective ability of the subject, the skill of the investigator, and the emotional state of the subject and the legal knowledge of the investigator. The purposes of interview is to establish facts necessary to prove the corpus delicti or the body of the crime, to obtain descriptive information to identify the suspect, to corroborate or disapprove information previously obtained, to verify evidence which the investigator has drawn from other evidence, to recover fruits of the crime, and to determine the location of the suspect. On the other hand, when we say interrogation, This is the formal systematic questioning of a criminal suspect for the purpose of securing an admission of guilt concerning his connection or participation in a crime under investigation. It is the skillful questioning of a suspect or hostile witness to divulge information concerning the crime under investigation. Example is custodial interrogation. Custodial interrogation is the stage wherein the police investigators begin to focus on the guilt of the suspect, and the suspect is taken into custody or deprived of his or her freedom of action in any substantial manner. It must be remembered, however, the police investigators cannot learn proper investigation merely by reading books. The success of interrogation depends on its legality, depends on its topic, on its physical insight and experience. The purposes of interrogation is to obtain information concerning the innocence or guilt of the suspect, to obtain a confession to the crime from the guilty suspect, and to induce the suspect to make admission. Finally, we have here the third tool of criminal investigation, which is the instrumentation. Instrumentation is the scientific examination of real evidences. It is the application of instruments and methods of the physical sciences in detecting crime. The sum of these sciences insofar as they are applied to crime detection is called criminalistics. In other words, the work performed in a crime laboratory is called criminalistics. Criminalistics may be defined as the recognition, identification, comparison, and evaluation of physical evidence by the application of the natural sciences. Instrumentation, however, is taken here to mean more than criminalistics. Therefore, fingerprint systems, modus operandi file, lie detector, and other investigative tools are contained within the scope of the term instrumentation. And that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Those are the three basic tools of criminal investigation. The tools discussed were just, as I've said, are basic tools of criminal investigation. We all know that crime is a dynamic in nature. It changes over time. And it goes with the criminal investigative tools also. Okay? It changes over time. Okay? So, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. I hope that you've learned something. I hope that you refresh your learnings from your fundamentals of criminal investigation, because as I've said, this is just a recap on what you have learned on your fundamentals of criminal investigation. In the next video, we will going to continue discussing, okay, the different topics under the checkup period. I hope to see you once again on our next video. Thank you and God bless.